A big budget problem on the horizon at a local mall. It's about to lose one of its anchor stores.
A Belk department store says it will soon shut down its Seminole Towne Center mall location in Sanford. West 2's Gail Pascoe-Brown is live in Sanford. And Gail, is this the beginning of a new trend?
Well, one economist I spoke with says that when it comes to malls, they're pretty much becoming dinosaurs. Trends and times are changing. And when you lose a big store like Belk, that's just not a good sign.
So once you lose anchor tenants, then you're going to lose a certain amount of traffic. Then that's
UCF economist Dr. Sean Snay points out the latest pullout from one of Central Florida's largest malls. Belk's is leaving Sanford Seminole Towne Center. That's bad news for Charlotte Garrett.
And I'm a Southern girl, and it's always been one of my favorite stores, one of my favorite department stores. So I was very disappointed to hear that.
Seminole Towne Center's general manager says the recently announced closing of Belk is not surprising, given the challenging economic environment. We have been monitoring the situation closely and are already exploring potential options to utilize the space. Seminole is not the only mall having to fill spaces. There are vacancies evident at Oviedo Marketplace.
You've got malls that maybe were struggling even prior to the recession. Then, you know, you go into this deep two-year-long struggle that we've been through, and it just really amplifies the problems that some of these malls are having. It's not just here. It's all around the country.
Dr. Snaith says times are changing, and retailers may have to change with the times.
The big thing is the trends. Trends are moving away from those enclosed malls, and malls that are, you know, struggling now are probably going to continue to struggle going forward.
Open-air shopping, like at Waterford Lakes Towne Center.
I prefer the indoor malls, especially in the heat like this.
Management here says that Seminole Towne Center's retail mix remains strong, with more than 120 quality stores, and we will continue to provide a great shopping experience.
As for Belk, 36 employees will also be leaving. I guess as far as shoppers are concerned, just make sure you listen out for the clearance sales. The store should be officially closed sometime in October. I'm Gail Pascoe-Brown, live in Seminole County for West 2 News.